Do you want to know some quick and easy ways to get Premiere Pro running much faster on any Mac or PC? If you do, stay tuned. Hey there, I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Now, if you're into Adobe Premiere or filmmaking, consider subscribing to the channel because that's what we're all about. Now, in this video, I'm gonna give you my top 6 tips and tweaks that you can do to Adobe Premiere Pro to help you edit faster, even if you're on a slower Mac or PC. Now, you know, we've all been there. We've all been trying to edit 4K footage. You pull it into Premiere, and what happens? It starts to slow down, or in some cases, it can crash. So I'm gonna give you my top 6 tips on ways that you can really speed up Premiere and get your timeline running smooth and buttery. So let's start with a really important one, one that you can moderate right before you open a new project. And that's your video rendering and playback options. To check this, go to File, New Project. If you have Adobe Premiere Pro 2020 installed, then one of the new features they've added is the Recommended option. This will check your graphics options and tell you what is recommended. This is the Mercury Playback Engine GPU acceleration for Metal on a Mac. And if you've not got the latest update of Premiere, then make sure it's selected, as this option will definitely make a difference to your editing. On a PC, you may find CUDA settings work the best, especially if you've got a NVIDIA card. This will help on making render times faster and making previews show up that weren't showing up before. Tip 2. Now that's done and your project is open, we'll clean up some of the preferences to best suit your software. First is deleting unused cache files. To do this, go into Preferences and go into the Media Cache folder. What you want to do is delete unused cache files. Go to where it says Media Cache Management and tick Automatically Delete Files Older Than X, and then just put in your desired limit. We've set it to 10 days, so it's always updated on this and you're not holding unused files for a long period of time. If you've done a project and you're never going to use it again, don't let it be stuck on your computer forever. Get rid of it. Of course, if you're working on longer projects, you may want to set this to 30 or 60 days. Tip 3, are you using enough RAM? To check your RAM usage, go to the folder just under Media Cache called Memory. Here it will tell you how much RAM you have and how much RAM is being used by Premiere Pro. Now you can actually help Premiere Pro run faster by allocating more system RAM. Go over to this here where it says RAM reserved for other applications and turn this to the lowest that you can. Now this will ensure more RAM is being used to run Premiere Pro and less is being used for everything else. It's basically a free RAM upgrade for your Mac or PC. Now, if you're only using Premiere Pro, also make sure other programs that you have open are now closed to prevent any conflicts and to free up more system RAM. Tip 4. Now, this is a really easy one, and it's probably one that you already do, but some people don't actually know about this. You can lower your playback quality. Go over to this drop-down box on the right-hand side of your screen, and instead of having it set at full, you can set it to a lower quality. So you can go to 1/4 or 1/8, and this will definitely help decrease some of your lag, especially if you're working with 4K or even higher quality footage. Now your footage should play back nice and smoothly. Another tip is the Mute FX option. So when you're editing and you've got a full timeline and all your clips are filled with effects, color grades, transitions, graphics, and all that kind of stuff, this will slow down Premiere. Now, the best way to solve this is to use this tool here. This will hide all of your effects that you've added, speeding up things very effectively. It doesn't actually remove the effects, it just puts them on standby. You can find the tool over here underneath your program panel. And if it isn't here, just simply hit the plus tool here, and this will bring up a panel of options. Find the effects and drag it over, and now you'll have that option permanently. Tip 6, the most effective way of making Premiere Pro run faster is using proxies. Using proxies basically makes another version of your clip, but in a much smaller file size. For example, if you're editing in 4K or 6K, you can create another copy of this footage. For example, I'll make my 1080 by 540. The smaller the size, the better. You just toggle this whilst you're editing, and when it comes to the export, untoggle it, and it will export the original file size. To do this, highlight all the clips you're going to be using, right click, and click Create Proxies. Go for whatever size you want, and then click OK. This will open up Media Encoder. Then when that's done, all you have to do is toggle the proxies in the media bar. If this isn't there, do the same as before. Click the plus icon and then drag it to the toolbar. So there we go, they are my top quick six tips to help you edit faster in Adobe Premiere. Now, I hope you really enjoyed them. And if you did, leave me a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. And let me know if there's any tips that I didn't mention there that you know of. I'd love to hear about them so we can feature them in a future video. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that like, that subscribe, and that notification bell. And I'll see you in the next video.